It looks like time.
Good evening. Okay. City Council of Grass Valley, regular city council meeting. Regular meeting of the Grass Valley City Council, Capital Improvement Authority and Redevelopment Successor Agency, 7 p.m. Tuesday, October 9th, 2018. And the City Council welcomes you to its meetings, which are scheduled at 7 p.m. on second and fourth Tuesdays of each month. Or if you're online or watching from television, we welcome you as well. Your interest is encouraged and appreciated. The meeting is being broadcast live on Comcast Channel 17, is being recorded by NCTV and is scheduled for rebroadcast on NCTV Channel 17. Please consult NCTV program listings as to the schedule at www.nevadacountytv.org. In addition, it's being broadcast live on TV. It is also being broadcast live on the internet at www.cityofgrassvalley.com. And look for the button Meetings on Video City Council in the lower portion of the homepage and follow the instructions. The meeting is also recorded on audio tape. Council chambers are wheelchair accessible and listening devices are available. Other special accommodations may be requested to the city clerk 72 hours in advance of the meeting. Action may be taken on any agenda item. Please turn off all cell phones or similar devices. Agenda materials are available at City Hall, City of Grass Valley Public Library, and the city's website by clicking on the PDF icon. Staff reports and background information related to regular agenda items are available at City of Grass Valley City Hall. Materials related to an item on this agenda submitted to the council after distribution of the agenda packet are available for public inspection in the city clerk's office at City Hall during normal business hours. Such documents are also available on the City of Grass Valley's website, subject to the city staff's ability to post the documents before the meeting. So the meeting is officially called to order. Pledge of Allegiance. Nancy, would you do that for us? Thank you.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Okay. Roll call, Christy.
Regular.
Here.
Councilmember Arbuckle.
Here.
Councilmember Foyer.
Here.
Vice Mayor Swarthout.
Yes.
Mayor Levine.
Yes.
Five here. Members present tonight.
Gender approval. The City Council reserves the right to hear items in a different order to accomplish business in the most efficient manner. There is nothing to report out of closed session, Ed, or anybody else. Introduction and presentations. We have none this evening. Public comment. This is a time limitation of 3 minutes per person for any item that are not on the agenda and within the jurisdiction of the interest of the city. Please come to the podium at this time and speak into the microphone. And on public comment, the council does not respond, but we will listen. If you wish to speak regarding a scheduled agenda item, please come to the podium when the item number and subject matter are announced and speak into the microphone. When recognized, please begin by providing your name and address for the record. Anyone wishing to submit written information at the meeting needs to furnish 10 copies to the city clerk in advance to allow for distribution to the city council, staff, and the media. Consent items. Public comment after I read all that. If anybody has any public comment, this is your chance.
One quick thing.
Are you waving?
Yes, I was.
Okay.
Thanks for recognizing me. Tim Keyser, city manager.
A lot of glare on this.
Just wanted to make sure everyone was aware that we will be having a public meeting tomorrow night reviewing the city's draft strategic plan, if I can actually put that out there, from 6 o'clock probably till about 7:30 for anyone that would like to come and kind of review it. It's mostly meant for the stakeholders that have already provided comments to make sure that we've captured everything that they have proposed for the city, and then we will be coming to a future council meeting here very soon.
Thank you. Any other public comment? Okay, not hearing or seeing anybody jumping up. The next item on the agenda is consent items. All matters listed under the consent calendar are to be considered routine by the City Council and will be enacted by one motion in the form listed. There will be no separate discussion of these items unless before the City Council votes on the motion to adopt. Members of the Council, staff, or public request items to be removed from the consent calendar for separate discussion and action. This is a roll call vote item. Any changes from the Council, staff, public? Not seeing any. The chair would be looking for.
Second that.
Christy, it's a roll call vote.
Councilmember Aguilar?
Yes.
Councilmember Arbuckle?
Yes.
Councilmember Foyer?
Yes.
Vice Mayor Swarthout?
Yes.
Mayor Levine?
Yes.
Motion carries 5-0.
So there are no items removed. There are no public hearings or administrative. Okay, brief reports. Were you here last month or last 2 weeks ago? Yeah.
I'll go first. I attended the LAFCO conference in Yosemite. I was able to go on the mobile workshop where we got a tour Bass Lake. It was a tree mortality. And we had a big problem with the drought up here, and we had a lot of trees that died. And our city took a really proactive approach of removing a lot of the as far as I know, most of them, if not all, the dead trees in our parks and in our city properties. So we took a proactive approach and eliminated the risk of trees falling down on people or roads and cars, where they have a huge issue of dead trees that are just falling across the road. When we were there, they had a tree fall across the road. And so that was something that was really, really pretty scary that they have to deal with. Fortunately, we haven't had that much of an issue. Other than that, it was a great conference, a lot of great classes. I also have a meeting this coming week for anybody that wants to attend it. It's the Solid and Hazardous Waste Commission. We have a new district manager who will be introducing himself there, and I will bring some more information back at the next meeting with his information and his phone number.
Thank you. 10-4. Maybe he'll come visit us. Yeah.
I'll invite him over.
Let's see. I attended the League of Women Voters Forum. Very informative. I'm going to do my normal thing from now until the election. Please make sure that you've, number one, are registered to vote. Number two, make sure that you read everything and not just go by what the titles read on any and all of the propositions, and do your research before you vote. It's really important that you vote, number one, and number two, to make sure it's an informed vote. I attended the Street of Dreams fundraiser. Great event, great. It was for Habitat of Humanity. They raise a lot of money. What an amazing organization that is. And another reminder to those people who drop off kids at the high school, please obey the traffic laws. Your kids that are in the car or you're dropping off, copy what you do. So when you cut out in front of people and almost get hit, that if once they start to drive, they're just going to say, if mom or dad or big sister does it, I can do it too. So please be mindful of that when you're dropping off or picking up your kids. I go by there, and I can't tell you how many times I've almost been hit because they're not paying attention. They're on their way to go to work or wherever. So anyway, that's it. That's it?
The bus. Yeah. Save gas, yeah. Lisa?
So I attended the Grass Valley Downtown Association board meeting a couple weeks ago, and they're continuing their little Thursday night market through the end of this month. So every Thursday over on North Auburn Street, there's six or eight fruit and vegetable vendors, and they've had some food trucks out there. It goes from 4 to 7. I also attended the Street of Dreams event for Habitat for Humanity, and I think the significance of that event for me is that they are completing the 16th home in the city of Grass Valley. And I'm not sure that those would have been built if it hadn't been the collaboration between the city and Habitat. And they had three of the families who are one has moved in and two whose homes are under construction speak. And what it means to those people to have a home, I could never put it into words, just the emotion of what the people felt, and it was very touching. And I believe that when their 16th home is finished, that they have plans to start on another 16. So I look forward to, and they're all in the city of Grass Valley, I look forward to working with them on that. And this Friday is the gala for the Center for the Arts. They are continuing to operate even though their facility is closed right now. So we all need to get out there and support them. I believe there's still some tickets available. If anybody's interested, can contact the center. Their office is right next door here. I think it's going to be a really great event.
So like 125 East Main Street?
At 125 East Main Street, City Hall. That's all I got.
Apartment hall in her room.
Yes.
Real simple. I had a ERC executive committee meeting as well as an ERC board meeting. The ERC is beginning to put together its 2019 plan, all ready for the next incoming folks to come in there and do the good work next year.
You're still going to be there, though, right?
I will still be there. Yes. But we did get some great input from the board, and as far as ideas and looking around, you know, how do we support some vocational type training here locally? We've been approached by the Curious Forge for some of that kind of training, and it could be a potentially good partnership there as far as training some local folks in the areas of welding and woodworking and things that our community seems to be lacking, and just the fact that we have incredible, you know, opportunities here that are just having a real struggle with trying to find good labor force all right, did I go too long?
Yeah.
That's it. That's your timer. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I was watching the clock and you're just going to overrun it.
Yeah, so the Curious Forge just triggered some good thinking there. And then I attended the Chamber's board meeting as well. And I was going to give a little bit of time for the chief to come up and talk about his patches. Or do you know that? As part of my 3 minutes, I'll give you my 3 minutes because I think it's important, and we see the pink patches everywhere now. Sorry. I'm always looking for the bus to throw you under.
Yep. Well, there it was. You found it. Well, thank you, council member and mayor and members of the council. So with that opportunity to talk a little bit about Grass Valley Police Department and the Pink Patch Project, I don't know if any of you are aware of what it's all about, so I'll give you less than 3 minutes. The Pink Patch Project started in Irwindale, California, Southern California, after in that agency they had a member touched by the impacts of breast cancer. As we know, breast cancer is very prevalent. It also benefits strongly from early detection, and so public awareness is important. Last year, Nevada City Police Department started locally doing something. They just got the patches and were selling them. And then we were approached, and actually I think I spoke to Monica up there this year about trying to do something a little bit more regional. So with the Grass Valley Police Department, Nevada City Police Department, and Nevada County Sheriff's Office, we are all in different variations wearing or have pink patches available to the public. They can purchase the patches either as singles or as a four-pack, including a CHP patch. The money that is raised goes to the Sierra Nevada Memorial Hospital Foundation breast cancer fund, which helps pay for mammograms for people who otherwise may not be able to afford them. That fund, actually, when it first started, the very first cancer detection was in a male. So breast cancer is something that can affect both men and women alike. Reby's Auto Parts was generous in actually purchasing all the patches for all the agencies. And when this came forward to me to talk about whether or not we could actually wear them on our uniforms, and Shelby, our evidence tech, has helped a lot with wanting to do this and helping make it successful in the organization. For me, it was about community-oriented policing on top of the benefits I just talked about. So much like you've recognized the pink patches, it generates conversation on the street that otherwise wouldn't happen. And after the person talks to the officer and says, hey, tell me about the pink patches, More than likely, they will engage in some other kind of conversation, which is where the rubber meets the road for us in law enforcement and really, truly community-oriented policing and having a relationship with our community. So that's kind of part of that. And then the money raised right now, we're shooting for a $10,000 goal by the end of October. Reby's was generous enough to take their proceeds from their golf tournament this year and apply it towards the Pink Patch Project fundraiser. So between that and current patch sales, we're right around a little over $8,000. So we're looking to close the rest of the gap. Keep your eyes open. We might have an event coming up where people would be able to drive through and maybe get a tasty morsel and purchase some pink patches. And then we have them available at the police department, sheriff's office, and at Nevada City Police Department. Does that give you a flavor? Thank you. All right, so thank you. So all Grass Valley police officers are wearing these for the month of October.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Chief. So the only thing I have to report, and I may have reported this with my feeble mind lately, the Christopher Stevens Memorial at the what's known as Bank Alley, which will be Christopher Stevens Court. Christopher Stevens was a consummate public person who worked for the United States to pass along the great things that the United States does, and was an emblem and a personality that really represented the greatest things that this country did. The arbors, the metal arbors, have all been made and they're ready for installation. And with Hills Flat Lumber being involved in that, and they will be contacting Tim. The plaque has been ordered for placement, and I think some public works movement has started, and others will take place. But the ceremony. Commemoration ceremony of Christopher Stevens, who is a native to the Grass Valley area and buried here and gave his life for the country, will be November 20, Thanksgiving, the Saturday of Thanksgiving weekend at 2 p.m. So that's when their family will be able to be here. And so we're moving forward on it in spite of how slow everything I do takes, but we're getting it done. We would like contributions. I don't know. We haven't done a very good job of letting people know that, but everything is being donated to the city, just about, including the arbors, the planters, which Hills Flat is making, the lighting, and the equipment for the drip irrigation, and the price tag somewhere around $14,000. I've raised probably $6,000 so far, but it's amazing what this community does. But we hope to have some other contributions. If anybody out there is listening, you can make a check payable to the Center for the Arts as our fiduciary nonprofit, so you can get a tax deductible donation, and it will mark the check for the Chris Stevens Memorial Fund. That's all I have. Meeting's adjourned.